up, guys? Welcome to the Coalition. My name is Jesse, and welcome to my first tutorial video. This is for Pokemon the Trading Card Game. I did a video before this, but it didn't really work out. Didn't turn out. I like Pokemon games, card games, TV shows, DS games, sorry, Game Boy games. I thought I might as well do a tutorial on the game. So, here we go. So in this tutorial, I will be going through the different card types, like what cards are, what they do, how to use them, the turn actions, how to start a game, and then the special conditions, so like the between turn steps. And I hope you find this informative and interesting. Most likely not, but hey, I'm doing this for fun, not for views. So, we will start with card types here. So I've got examples of card types here. So the most important card that you've got in your deck is, of course, the Pokemon card. Different Pokemon. So most of these cards are either basic, stage 1, or stage 2. Stage 1 and Stage 2 cards are also called Evolution cards. So, if I just put down those one and that one. So, we've got a card here. So, this is Larvitar. This is, as you can see at the top, a basic Pokemon. I'm not sure if you can read that. So, that is before the Pokemon evolves. And then we've put that down too. Jesus. Then we've got the Stage 1. So, this would be stage one, which is Pupitar, the evolvement of a Larvitar. So that one goes there. So that evolves into that. Damn it. And then finally, we've got the stage two. Now this is shiny. You might not be able to sort of tell this one very well because the shiny lights will be in the way. But this is Tyranitar. This is the stage two. This evolves from the stage one Pokemon. Now, to use these, you need another type of card, which is the energy card. Now, energy cards help or make or allow Pokemon to attack. So, if we just get up, this one. Alright, so we've got the basic stage 1 or stage 2 here. We've got the name, we've got what type of Pokemon it is here. So just here, and then the health. If we look down here, we've got these two, this symbol here. This is energy. So that star symbol means colorless energy. If we get Tyranitar up, we've got black here. So that would be dark energy. The different types of energy you can get are grass, fire, water, electric, psychic, fighting, dark, metal, and fairy energy. So those are the different types of Pokemon you can get, minus dragon and colorless, because you can't get dragon, or you can, but they don't count as basic energy cards. Special energy cards, however, are different. You can get dragon and colorless, by special energy. So I've got example of energy here. So this would be is fighting energy, so the card with a fist on it. So you would put this under Pokemon, and this would allow me to use the move that uses one energy. So that would be Mountain Munch, and this allows me to discard the top card of my opponent's deck. So we'll just leave that down there. So the other energy cards you can get, I said that already. Now we move on to trainer cards. Now you've got three. Oh shit, what was that? Ah, falling! Fuck! If we just move these down here, give room. Alright, so there's three types of trainer cards. You've got stadium cards, supporter cards, and item cards. Now, item cards are items that you either one turn use, or you place on your Pokemon. So this card is a one-turn use. This is Professor's Letter. As you can see at the top, it's an item. And this allows me to search my deck for... Can I focus that? Hang on. Focus. That's not going to focus. So this allows me to search my deck for two basic energy cards. So that would be, example, one of these. Next, we've got supporter cards. So supporter cards are always one turn use. And this one is Turno. I think that's how you pronounce it. I'm not sure. But this allows me to draw three cards. Last of all, we've got stadium cards. Most of the time, stadium cards are used to affect both players. So this one is Reverse Valley. I'm not sure if you can read this on the actual camera. Down here it says, choose which way the card faces before you play it. The attacks of this player's dark Pokemon do 10 more damage to your opponent's active Pokemon. And then on this side, it says, choose which way the card faces before you play it. Any damage done to this player's Pokemon, so this player's metal Pokemon by an opponent's attack, is reduced by 10. So as you can see, this card affects both players. So you can choose which way that goes, so you can flip it around, etc. Alright, so I think that covers most of the basics. Now I will, hang on, just change that, there we go. So I shall move these out of the way. I'll put these over to one side. I'll put over there, basic stage one, basic stage one, stage two there. And then these on top, just so you can sort of just have a look at that. Actually, there's no point, is there? So I'm just gonna wrap these up, put these back in the deck. Come here, you bastard, thank you very much. I'll just chuck that over back onto that deck, because that doesn't go in this deck. What's that, right? So as you can see, I've got green sleeves on my deck, which helps to protect my cards. I'm just gonna quickly shovel that. All right, next we're going to talk about the layout and how to start a game. So basically, to start a game, you first shake your hands with your opponent. Next, you flip a coin. Hang on, I've got to... I have got a special Pokemon coin here. Just get back behind the camera. I've got a special Pokemon coin. This is a Zygarde coin. So it is, what is it, limited? No, it's not limited edition. No, it's an official Pokemon card. I've got a Gyarados one somewhere as well. So I'll just put that down there for now. All right, so you shake hands with your opponent, but then you flip a coin. So I'm gonna choose heads. So this side here is heads, this side is tails. So I'm gonna flip, that's tails. Actually, so I should have chosen first. So I choose, I don't know, heads. Oh, good luck. All right, so that's heads. So that allows me to choose who goes first. Now, there are perks and cons for going first. So the perk one, I think I'd rather go second. Going first disables you from attacking first, so you cannot attack on the first turn of the game. So this is good for player two because he can just instantly attack. But a pro for being second is, also a pro for being second is that you know what your opponent is going to use. So if you've got, say, water Pokemon, and he's got fire Pokemon, you know, I don't know what I'm saying here. It made sense in my head, don't judge me. Alright, anyway, so then you shuffle your deck. So I've just been shuffling behind the camera. I'm just going to do that here anyway. Just to give it some authenticity. Oh my god, my cards are falling out of my hand. That's not good. There we go. Alright, so I've shuffled that. Now you draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards. Now this will be your hand. After you've drawn... Get behind here. After you've drawn your 7 cards, you check to see if you have basic Pokemon. I'm just going to flip all these cards around. So you check to see if you've got basic Pokemon in your hand. So you've got energy here, energy, energy, basic Pokemon, energy, basic Pokemon, supporter card. So this is good. I can use this. So if you don't have basic Pokemon in your hand, what do you do? So first you reveal your hand to your opponent, and then you shuffle your hand back into your deck, and then draw 7 more cards. If you don't, if you still don't have any basic Pokemon, you repeat. So this is called a mulligan. Now I've got basic Pokemon in my hand, so I don't have to mulligan. So each time your opponent shuffles his or her hand back into his or her deck, because he or she had to mulligan, you draw an extra card. So the person who doesn't have to mulligan draws an extra card. So let's just get onto the layout here. So just going to put my deck up there. So next, so after you've done that, you put, you get both or all of your basic Pokemon. So I'm just going to get my 2, and you put these as your benched Pokemon. So the maximum benched Pokemon you can have is 5. So with the layout, so I'm going to choose an active Pokemon. Active Pokemon is going to be Riolu. So imagine your active Pokemon is the Pokemon you have just thrown. Sorry about the camera wiggle. You have just thrown this Pokemon out into the battlefield. Your benched Pokemon are your Pokemon that are still in their Pokeballs around your belt. Sorry if like my voice keeps trailing off to one side. I am having to move back and forth from behind the camera to over here so I can actually... Oh, shit. Okay. So I can actually do things. So after you've done that, you pick up 6 more cards. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't look at these cards. These cards are going over on this side here. I'll just move you over there. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are your prize cards. How prize cards work is each time you defeat one of your opponent's Pokemon, you pick up a prize card. Now, after you've put the prize cards down, so basically you're supposed to put your active Pokemon down face down, and then both players flip over their Pokemon and the game starts. Now, because this isn't the full layer, I'm going to just put out the full layer. So I'm just gonna put them face down just because, I don't know. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there. Oh my god, look at that. That is perfectly in screen. So you've got your 5 cards there. Put your active Pokemon out. Your discard pile goes on top there. So your discard pile is where all... Shit. Is where all your fainted Pokemon or used cards go. So I'm just going to put these down so they're straight so they don't look odd on camera. Well, they still look odd, but they look more straight than... There we go. So that goes there. That goes there. All right, so that is the layout for a Pokemon game. Now, technically, you would have another spot here in the middle of these two cards for a stadium card, which I went through previously. That is the layout. So you've got your deck, which has all of your cards in it, the minimum and maximum amount of cards you can have in your deck for a competitive battle is 60 cards. So this 60 cards consist of basic stage 1 and stage 2 Pokemon cards, energy cards, depending on what type of deck you have. So in this deck, I have got fighting and grass, I think. Yeah, fighting and grass. So I've got fighting and grass energy. And the deck also consists of trainer cards. So these are item cards, supporter cards, and stadium cards. Now, I'm just going to put that back in there. So let's start playing again. So basically, I'm just going to draw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 new cards. So I've got basic, energy, 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 energy. So I'm just going to pick up one of these. That was an energy. That's fine. I'm going to switch it with that. So how we start. So say I go first. So I can, actually, let's just say that we're in the middle of a battle, because if you go first, you can't attack. If you go second, you're in a bit of a, so we'll put the energy underneath Riolu like that. And we will use Smash Punch. Now, because Smash Punch is a move that only requires one, we can use that. Now, if I just get all my damage counters out, these are dice, but I prefer dice over damage counters just because they're so much easier to use. So, just put that there. This is going to be the opponent. So, I did 30 damage to this Pokemon. So, you put 30 damage on there. So 30 damage in dice would just be putting the dice to 3. And then it says flip a coin. If tails, the attack does nothing. So we flip heads. So the attack will do 30 damage. If it landed on tails, you would take that off and that did no damage. That did 30. So what happens next? So after, sorry, before you do anything, you're supposed to draw a card. So we had that. So after you draw a card, so you do any of these. So you put a basic, you can, so you don't have to do these in any particular order, but you put a basic Pokemon down from your hand into your bench, as many Pokemon as you want. You can evolve a Pokemon. You may evolve a basic Pokemon to a stage 1, or a stage 1 to a stage 2. When a Pokemon evolves, it keeps all cards attached to it, and keeps any damage it already has, but it can't use the attacks or the abilities of the Pokemon from which it evolved. Any special conditions, so this would be sleep, confusion, poison, etc., like confusion, they end when your Pokemon evolves. The way evolution works is your basic stage 1 Pokemon have to be out for a whole turn before they can evolve. So after you've done that, you can attach an energy to one of your Pokemon. So we've already done that with Riolu. You play any trainer cards. Now, I don't have any trainer cards in my hand, so I can't do that. You can retreat your Pokemon once per turn. I'm not going to do that because I don't need to retreat that. So after you've done that, you can use any abilities. So some Pokemon have abilities. None of my Pokemon do at the moment. So after you've done that, you attack. So when you are ready to attack, first, make sure that you've done everything in step 2 that you want to do. Once you attack, your turn is over, so you can't go back later. Attacking has 3 simple steps. Once you get it figured out, you'll be attacking like a pro. So, on the first turn of the game, the player starting Pokemon skips this step. Once this player has done all of his or her activities, the turn ends. After that, each player attacks as normal. So, first thing to do is check the energy attached to your active Pokemon. So that would be this. So we've got 1 energy attached to Riolu. So you'll need the right amount of energy attached to a Pokemon for it to attack. For example, Riolu. Riolu's smash punch costs one fighting energy. So you have to have at least one fighting energy for Riolu to use this attack. Pokemon with things that say two energy would obviously need two, at least two, and so on and so forth. I think the maximum that I've seen is five, which is my Tyranitar, which needs five dark energy, which you saw before. Next is you check the weaknesses and resistance of your opponent's Pokemon. So if we take this off, our opponent's Pokemon is weakness to grass. Unfortunately, our Pokemon is not grass. So some Pokemon have weaknesses or resistance to Pokemon of certain other types. So that's marked in the lower corner, like I showed you. For example, Pupitar is weakness to grass. If the attack does damage, your opponent's active Pokemon takes more damage if it has a weakness to the attacker's type. So say if I attacked with a grass Pokemon, it would do times 2 damage. So instead of doing 30, that would do 60, and so on. Pretty simple. Next is you put damage counters on your opponent's active Pokemon. So when you attack, put one damage counter for each 10 damage your Pokemon does. So us doing 30 damage, normally you would put 3 damage counters on, but I just put a dice saying 30. I'm saying 3. So once your attack is complete, your turn ends. So next we'll go through the between turn steps. So before a game continues to the next player, take care of special conditions. So you've got poisoned, burned, asleep, and paralyzed in that specific order. So then you apply the effects of any abilities, between turns. After both players have done these things, check to see if affected Pokemon were knocked out, then start the next player's turn. So special conditions include asleep, burned, confused, paralyzed, and poisoned. So asleep, you turn your active Pokemon to the left, or counterclockwise, to show that it's sleeping. If a Pokemon is asleep, it can't attack or retreat. And between turns, you flip a coin. If you flip heads, the Pokemon wakes up. But if you flip tails, it stays asleep. Now you've got burns. Hang on, I'll just get things from here. I'm not sure if... No, that's not it. That's just my Gyarados coin. I'm not sure if you can see that. Gyarados coin. There it is. Hello. I'm not sure where my other one went, actually. Oh, whatever. So, burned has an icon like this, so two band-aids. So, if a Pokemon is burned, it may take damage between turns. So if it's damaged, put a damage marker on it. Between turns, the owner of the burn Pokemon flips a coin. If he or she flips tails, you put two damage counters on the burn Pokemon. A Pokemon cannot have two burn markers. If an attack gives it another burn marker, the new burn condition simply replaces the old one. Make sure your burn marker never looks different from your damage counters. Sorry. It does look different from your damage counters. My mind just went into a total blank then. Alright, so... Whoa, my god, falling over. So we take that off. Next is confusion. So, a confused Pokemon is upside down. So it's got its head facing towards you to show that it's confused. If a Pokemon is confused, you must flip a coin before attacking with that Pokemon. If you flip heads, the attack works normally. But if you flip tails, your Pokemon receives 3 damage counters, and the attack ends without further effect. Next is paralysis. So paralysis, you turn your Pokemon clockwise, or right. If a Pokemon is paralyzed, it can't attack or retreat, and you move the special condition during the between turn step, if your Pokemon was paralyzed at the beginning of your last turn. Next, we have got poisoned. So, a poisoned marker looks green and it has a white skull in the middle. I can't find my one, so we're just going to use the back of the burned one. So, you put your burn, your poison symbol down in the lower corner. And once your Pokemon is Once your Pokemon is poisoned, it takes damage between turns. When a Pokemon is poisoned, put a poison marker on it, and you put a damage counter on each poisoned Pokemon between turns. So a Pokemon can't have two poison markers. If an attack gives it another, it's basically the same as fire. You just replace it and start again. So now we remove special conditions. So moving to the bench removes all special conditions. The only special conditions that prevent Pokemon from retreating are asleep and paralysis. Since asleep, confused, and paralyzed all rotate the Pokemon card, whichever one happened last to the Pokemon is the only one that is still in effect. Since poison and burned use markers, they don't affect other special conditions. An unfortunate Pokemon could be burned, paralyzed, and poisoned all at the same time. So, after you've done that, what else is there? I think that's all I need to do for this video. Next video, I will be doing a proper demonstration on how to actually play a Pokemon game. So, I'll be playing with my friend either Lachlan or Kane. I can't remember which one I'm gonna do it with. Well, I don't know yet. I can't remember. But yeah. So if you like this video, please give it a like, a comment, and subscribe if you want more content similar to this. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I shall see you later. Bye.